Diana Caha. I've written the book, The Round Diet. I've written tons of articles. I'm a graduate of culinary schools, and I've even instructed at a few. This is my kitchen series of weird tools and how to use them. That's so good. These are one of my favorite tools. I have two of them because I can't do without them, and you might wonder what they are, and I'm going to show you. So let me take a sip of my mojito, the other tool I use. And I'm going to shred some cucumbers and some carrots, and I'm going to show you another tool right here, and then this is going to come into play. So we've got two tools, shredder or peeler, and this, and I don't even know what it's called. So let's just go ahead and peel this. So I'm going to make a mess here, and there's a reason I'm making a mess. You'll see why. Peeled part of that. Now I'm going to peel part of this. So you can see this tool in itself is really great. You could even do designs. Like, I'll show you. I should have done it in the other one. If you want to do a cool cucumber design, you can do stripes. And now when I cut it, it's going to have designs on it. So you see I have this big mess here. This is where this tool comes in handy. I just scoop it up and put it in the bowl. And this bowl, I always have a garbage bowl, and I learned that from Rachel Ray. Not personally, but I watched her show. So that's another favorite tool, is to have a garbage bowl, just like this. This is one of my favorite tools. It's a chantry knife sharpener, and there's nothing like dull knives. So all you do is you just set this down, put your knife in, and pull it like this, and it's going to get super, super sharp. I'm just going to slice right through this tomato. Piece of cake. I didn't smash the tomato because it's so sharp. So here these little dimples are called hollow ground. And what's good about them is if you're cutting something sticky like cheese, it'll break the vacuum so you can cut more easily. And I can still sharpen this on my chantry. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And I'm going to cut through a tomato because I don't have cheese here right now. And it's so much sharper. So this is totally worth it. You can have one great knife and keep it sharp forever if you have this chantry. And that's what it looks like. I want to show you another great tool. This one is one that my mom showed me. It's a cheese shredder, and it shreds cheese really finely. So I love it for Parmesan cheese, and I'm going to show you just how fine it is. It's really pretty to do on, blind cheese, excuse me. It's really pretty to put on spaghetti. And it looks really good on red right here. Look at how fine that is. It's like fluff. Let me just show you with some cheese and show you what's different about this shredder if I did big shreds instead of the little fine shreds. So let me just go ahead and do that. Again, I like to think of this as a workout, so I really put everything into it. There. So see how big that is? And again, I'm using my favorite tool, big pieces. Now this is going to take some doing because it's so big. And this would be great for coleslaw. And I love red cabbage. It has lots of antioxidants in it. That's why it's red. Okay, I need another plate. What goes with red? This goes with red. Okay. Again, my tool. See why I like this so much? Okay. Oh, this looks like coleslaw almost already. Oops. There you go. And you know what? I do have a video on my favorite everybody loves salad dressing, and you should really try it because it goes great on red cabbage, zucchini. I take two at once, and this is the way I got my daughter to eat vegetables and spaghetti. She never knew. I've told her later, but she didn't know at the time. I just take two of these like this, and I start shredding them. So again, another favorite tool. You have to be careful if your knuckles here, because I've kind of made spaghetti with knuckles in it, I think, because I accidentally scraped my knuckles. There we go, okay, garbage bowl. And this is just gonna go in spaghetti. And the way you get it in the spaghetti is with my favorite tool, that. So I would just scoop it up, and of course I have to find some place to put it in the meantime. Oops, a little loud. So I'm just gonna set that aside for later. So whenever I have a mojito, I wanna have some nuts. And where did I put them? Oh, over here. Oh, oops, excuse me, nuts. I have almonds that are covered in wasabi. They go so well with a mojito. Mm. I should really do this on both sides so I don't end up with one bigger arm or something. And there again, my tool, shredded carrots. And I'm gonna go get a plate to put that on. If I can find one. Go. Carrots, and you know what, there's a little bit of cheese in there, and you know, that's kind of a good idea. And this, it's shaped like a piece of garlic for people who may forget what it is after they bought it, because you know how you buy some strange tool and you don't know what it is. So all you do is, this is a way to get all that stuff off that's so hard to get off, and I just put it in my garbage bowl. And look, wow, it's, I almost got it all off. And again, exercise. So look at that, compared to the other one. It has the outer layer removed, so half your job is done. It's time for a mojito break.